going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Ha! Yeah, boy!
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the newest episode of Inside AMG. Today, I'm at the Circuit de Catalunya in Barcelona, Spain, where I'm actually going to learn how to drive a race car. Can't believe I'm saying this right now. Now, if you want to learn more about our race cars, you can check out episode M, where we give you an exclusive look behind the scenes of our GT3 production lines. I've already successfully completed the advanced and the pro trainings of the AMG experience, so today I'm gonna get to drive the Mercedes AMG GT3. But I'm not gonna be alone in today's episode. Of course, we got an expert who is none other than racing driver Maro Engel. And here he
is. Hey, Felix, how are you doing?
Very good. How about yourself?
Really good, thank you.
Very nice to have you here today. I mean, most people already recognize you. You've been on the show a couple of times, but why don't you introduce yourself?
Sure. I'm Maro Engel, Mercedes AMG performance driver and brand ambassador, and also one of the instructors in the AMG experience. So we'll make sure that you get the AMG experience today.
Nice, awesome. I mean, I have to say, I was a bit nervous about today, but you, with your experience, especially on this car, the Mercedes AMG GT3, I know I'm in very capable hands, and I can't wait to get going. So do we hit the track right now?
Take it easy. We will hit the track, but on the simulator first.
Ah, okay. Well, so then let's get going.
Let's go. All right, that looks pretty good. Are you ready to hit the track?
Absolutely, let's do this.
Okay, so we're gonna go on track now and practice braking points and hitting the apex.
Perfect. All right, let's do
that. All right, Felix, we're here on track now. We're here at turns 7, 8, and 9, our section training. We're gonna focus on hitting the braking points, turn-in points, getting the car to the apex, and then nicely accelerating back out. I'll drive first, show you, and then you'll take the wheel and hopefully do the same.
Nice, finally some racetrack action. Let's do this.
Let's go. All right, so you can see, looking already in towards turn 7, we've got cones set up on track. The blue cones, braking reference markers, and then the first orange cone, which will be your turning point. That's okay. Really important. That's from where we turn the car in on the ideal racing line, bring the car to the apex, where you, again, you'll have a cone at the apex of the corner, which you need to be as close as possible to that. So we'll have a first run and go for it.
Right.
All right, turn in point to the apex, and then accelerating back out.
Nice.
The available space, braking, turn in points, bring the car over to the apex, and accelerating back out. And that was those three corners already.
Looks smooth and easy when you do it.
That's like, the secret.
Yeah.
I want to bring the car as close as possible to the limit, but don't go over. So it needs to be smooth. Without the car having big slides. As soon as you have big slides, you start losing time.
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
I am, ready as ever.
So the key thing is your viewing technique. So where you look is where you're gonna drive. So you always need to be ahead of the game. So you wanna be looking, as you approach the corner, you wanna be looking at your braking point. When you're at your braking point, you wanna be looking at your turning point. When you're at the turning point, you're already looking at the apex.
All right.
Because that's where you're naturally gonna steer to, go to. There's a simple saying, which is your hands follow your eyes.
All right, all right.
Let's go for a first run.
Let's go.
All right, that's it. Turn in point to the apex. Gently accelerate back out now. And braking, that's it. To the apex and gently accelerating back out. All right, very good.
All right, but I feel like I've gotten to know this crucial part of the track a little bit better now.
For sure, and that's the key part. Now we're gonna piece all these different sections together to one whole lap when you go out in the GT3 race car.
Nice, nice. All right. Ride model. I feel like I've done everything to prepare myself for this experience. Spent some time in the sim, gotten to know the track. I think I know the most crucial parts of the track already pretty well. Do I actually get to drive the car now? I mean, we can already hear the engines in the background. I want to get going now.
Before we drive the car, let's briefly talk about the car.
Okay.
Our AMG GT3, one of the most successful race cars out there, winner of the 24 Hours of Spa this year. 600 horsepower approximately, rear-wheel drive, 6-speed sequential gearbox, just under 1,300 kilos homologation weight, so very light, very direct, very low to the ground, a lot of downforce. So you can see the big wing at the rear of the car, you have the front diffuser to balance it out, the car is pressed to the ground, the faster you're going, the more grip you get. And then finally, the tires, slick tires, so huge grip, but they need temperature. When they're cold, it's like ice, so as soon as you leave pit lane, take it easy. But why don't you head outside to our friends from Michelin? They'll tell you a little bit more about the tires. And once you're done there, you get suited and booted. And our friend and colleague, Gabriella Piana, will take you on the passenger seat first for a lap around the track.
Sounds awesome. So I'll head outside and see you later. Thanks.
See you soon.
You look like just the man I need. Hi.
Oh, really? Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Why don't you tell the viewers at home who you are and what you do at Michelin?
Okay, so I'm Anthony, and I'm a technical advisor for GT cars for Michelin.
Ah, perfect. Just the man we need. So what can you tell me about the different tires that are on the Mercedes-AMG GT3?
Okay, so let's start from the beginning. Here you can see two different tires. So wet tires with the groove things and the sculpture to evacuate the more water and to go on a wet condition on track. And here is the kind of tire we are going to use today because of the sun and because it's dry condition. So it's a slick tires.
Already feels quite sticky, I have to say. If you touch it, it doesn't feel like a regular road tire.
You have to know that we have three components of different tires, of slick tires here. And each compound is working for a very specific temperature, track temperature window.
We're probably not going to use the compound for the really hot temperatures, right?
We are not going to use the compound for really high temperatures, but we are not still using the very low temperature because the sun is out and the sun is warming the track.
Ah.
And the track is already around 20, 25 degrees. So we are going to use the medium spec, which has been developed with AMG car and AMG engineers. And that's it. I'm sure you will have a lot of fun with this tire and for a long time.
Awesome. Thank you very much for this brief introduction.
Thanks to you.
So for me, it's now time to get suited up and get into the race car.
Good. Have fun.
Thank you.
I'm gonna try and implement everything on my lap later on.
Wow.
nothing can prepare you for that. Nothing. Nothing comes even close. I need to calm down. I'm like literally pumped up to the brim with adrenaline.
Wow, that was a pretty amazing taster. Crazy, crazy.
Good lap with Gabriele?
Oh yeah, definitely. And the cornering speeds you can achieve in that thing, that's just mind-blowing.
The grip, right?
Oh yeah, so good. But I can't wait to have a go at it myself.
All right, first step, Let's choose a seat.
Okay, okay. I'm gonna be confident. I'm gonna start with one of the smaller ones.
Of course, I wanna have a snug fit.
Yeah, that's not gonna work. Yeah. Yeah, that's more like it. That's more like it. That feels good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that one.
Sounds good. All right, let's get this in the car.
Wonderful.
All right, seats in the car. So why don't you get in, see if you're comfortable, and we'll check the belts for the length.
Awesome. All right, let's see if I can find a dignified way to get in here.
Just like a pro.
Ah, yeah.
Nice and snug.
Tight. Nice and tight, nice and snug fit, but not too tight. Yeah, I feel comfortable.
Very good. All right, let's put the belts on.
All right.
So you got the center lock for the 6-point belt. Yep, between your legs, pull that up. How does that feel?
Safe. I feel very safe.
That's very good. So safety-wise, we have this carbon seat cell here. We're the only manufacturer to use that. So the credo was, if we're going to build a GT3 car, it needs to be the safest on the market. So we are the only ones using this carbon safety cell here, which means we need to move the pedals and the steering wheel because the seat is always fixed. To do that, first of all, I'm going to get you to put the steering wheel on. Just press it on. Just push. There we go.
Nice.
And then we unlock from under the steering wheel, and now you can move up, down, closer, further away.
Ah, nice. Just like a regular car.
Yep. Just not electric, though.
Yeah.
You know, remember, it's all that weight saving.
Yep, yep.
And now, pedal box, you have this lever on your right side. Push that, and the pedal box will slide towards you, or you can push it away from you.
That's handy. Nice. Guess I'll push it the farthest to the farthest point.
Yeah, you are pretty tall.
Long legs. But this feels very nice.
So now next step is I'll explain you the functions of the car.
Now there's a lot going on already on the steering
wheel. There's a lot going on the steering wheel, but we'll go through it step by step. Let's start with the paddle shift. You know that from your regular AMG.
Right.
Right paddle to shift up, left paddle to shift down. We have the starter button here on the right-hand side. We have the pit limiter here, top right. Protected so that you don't accidentally activate it.
Oh, yeah.
That wouldn't be great in a racetrack situation, only in pit lane. We have the radio button to communicate back with the pits. We have the neutral button. We have a chrono button to set a marker in the dash. And then obviously we have the center console where we have things like ABS in yellow.
Oh, yeah.
We have 11 settings for ABS. We have 12 settings for traction control in blue. So you can fine tune the perfect setting for this tire, tire age, fuel mileage for the track, track conditions. So there's a lot going on there. More standard, we have, very important though, the main switch, just like in your home. We have the white button is the reverse button. Once you have the main switch on and there's power in the circuit, you can put ignition on. And then the next step would be to start the car.
All right, awesome.
So why don't you press the main switch, blue button.
All right.
And now, flick the ignition switch to on.
You can actually hear it come to life.
That's it. Now it really comes to life, and the dash ahead of you is up and running. So you have the big end in the middle at the moment. That's your gears, so which gear you're running. Then you have ABS, what setting, traction control, which engine map,
right,
the fuel load, the speed of the vehicle. You have the lap time diff, which updates every 100 meters, whether you're faster or slower than your reference lap time. Green if you're faster, red if you're slower. We have the water temperature. We have the lap count, and then obviously tire pressures and tire temperatures. RPM at the top, and the shift lights at the top. The shift lights run together. Once they get red, time to shift to the next gear.
Perfect. Everything in plain view. Just the information I need. Very nice. Time to get going.
Let's get your hands, helmet, gloves, and get going.
Awesome. Hello again.
Wie geht es, Felix? Geht's dir gut?
Gut, gut.
Yeah, that's it. Right? So just floor it in the pit limiter. Just keep it floored, because if you keep it floored, it's going to be smooth. If you manage it yourself, it's going to be a horrible experience.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Let's go! Right? There you have it.
Oh, wow! I can't believe I'm actually driving a GT3 car.
We are not only driving, we are going to drive it fast. There you go, you can give it a little bit the beans.
Oh, wow. This right. Feels...
Look down and just go for it. You can floor it now. There you go. You keep going, keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. On the brakes. Very good, down two gears. Very good. You can go into the apex, yeah.
God, there is so much to think about.
There's a lot. Just go for it now. Yeah, one down. Very good. And you can go up the gear again. Accelerate, up the gears. Fantastic. Yeah, cut everything. Use everything, Felix. Just slide on the brake, off the brakes. And now slightly pick up the power and roll it all the way down and floor it now for the straight. Let me hear it. Let me hear it scream, Felix. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Brake, yeah. More braking, more braking, more braking. Yeah. You have to press the pedal hard. You have to hit it like it did something to you.
There is so much pressure that you need to put on there.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
Exactly. You really have to go for it. You have to go after it. Go on the power. Power, power, power. Now on the brakes. Release the brakes. You turn in. Very close to the curb. We are going to the chicane. Accelerate a little bit. Braking. Brake, 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 brake. Turn in. Very good. Yeah, into the right. Go for it now. Left, stay on the left, upper gear, very good. Keep building up the power smoothly, full power, full power, full power, full power. Keep it floored, keep it floored, keep going!
Oh yes!
Now keep going, and then when I tell you to brake, you really go hard. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Ha! Yeah boy, yeah boy!
Oh my word!
It's like hitting a wall, I tell you. very good, man. Good boy. Keep going, upper gear. Now go for it again, floor it all the way full. Fantastic, using the curve like I showed you, using every millimeter. To the right, brake. Yeah, I see the confidence is coming. Right. So upper gear to the left. Now very light braking. No more brakes. Yeah, look down the road. Go for it, full. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Keep going until I tell you to brake. Go, 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 brake. Brake, hard, hard. Yeah, boy, that's it. You never forget, you have to go hard on them. Right?
Wow.
Full, full, full. Fantastic. Yes, yes, yes. Brake. Very good. In. Release the brakes. That was very good. Look down the road and now start building up the power smoothly and go for it. Full. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Brake. Down one. In. Release the brakes. Look down the road where you want to be and build up the power and full. Pin to the floor. It's a little bit a different experience. Like normally you do this and the instructor says, slow down, slow down. Yeah. And I'm just going to shout at you, keep going, just go. Brake later, stay flat. Go for it.
This is just so crazy. Forgive me for being so quiet during yours.
I actually am surprised. I've been told, Felix really talks a lot. You're barely saying anything, don't you?
Wow.
Right, and with the head to the pits. Fantastic. Woohoo! Well done, Felix. Now, pit limiter. You can put the pit limiter on. Now, press it once. There you go, floor it. Floor it. Fantastic. In order to stop now, you clutch it in and you stop braking with your right foot.
Okay.
So clutch in and stop with your right foot and engine off. Just press once the engine button, engine start button. Yeah. Are you shaking?
I hope I'm not shaking too much. That was crazy. That was just crazy.
Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
But I definitely, thank you so much for this experience. Seriously.
It was a blast, absolutely.
But I need to get changed. I think I lost about 10 pounds of sweat.
Ah, okay. Is that what I'm smelling then?
Yeah, probably. Okay, it's just sweat.
Well done, Felix.
Wow. Wow.
So, how was it?
Unbelievable. It was everything I expected it to be and so much more. Just the craziest experience ever.
That's good to hear. Well, let's look at your data. That's what we have right here.
Ooh, nice.
Data of your drive and the video analysis as well, so we can watch your onboard and improve your driving.
Awesome.
Let's take a seat.
Cool.
You reached 250 kph.
Ah, so okay. Those lines quick. Are the speed.
It's the speed line, exactly. Uh-huh. And the reference lap time from the Pro is 285.
Wow.
So he's a bit braver, braking quite a bit later, holding the throttle, accelerating for longer, but then, and that's the big difference, you know, your braking's a bit softer, 22 bar, it's more like a road car type of braking. He hits the brake at 100 bar.
100 bar.
That's five times almost as much pressure on the brake pedal. So race car, hit the brake really, really hard.
And I thought I did quite well. I thought I was very quick, but especially seeing like the difference in brake pressure, that's just, that's very, very annoying, I have to say.
Well, I mean, that's the good thing is that's why you're here, you know, to improve, to take the next step in your driving. And that's what you can really see here on this analysis. Some of your corner speeds are looking really, really good and really promising. Like right here, you know, you're bang on the money. I mean,
nice.
Exactly the same speed at that point. Then other areas, like
lucky.
Mentioned, you gotta sort of accelerate out of the corner a little bit more. But in general, the general trend is the cornering speeds are quite good, but more acceleration in outer of the corners and then harder braking into the corners.
So there's definitely a lot of data to digest and analyze, and there's also a lot of room for improvement for me.
You just have to come back.
I will. But first of all, thank you so much for making this possible, and thank you so much for letting me drive one of the GT3 cars. Really appreciate that.
It was a true pleasure.
Thank you very much. And before we dive deeper into the data, it's time for me to say goodbye to you at home. An absolute blast to be here with the AMG experience. Today you got to see what it takes to drive a race car. It definitely takes a lot more than I have to give, being an everyday driver. Just unbelievable what these people, the real race drivers, can do behind a steering wheel. So if you liked what you've seen today, don't forget to like the video. Also drop us a comment down below, letting us know what you would like us to shoot next. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the little bell icon so you get notified whenever we upload a new video. So until the next one, bye-bye.